In this video, we are going to perform unit conversions for molar amounts in cases where we wanted to go from, say, gram moles to kilogram moles or kilogram moles to pound moles. Now, you might think, you know, why do we have all these types of different units for moles? And it comes about that we're talking about large-scale industrial processing. We don't necessarily want to talk about how many gram moles of a product we're producing, whereas if we're in a lab and working on a benchtop in a small flask, maybe a gram mole is an appropriate unit for the amount that we're working with. So this can be one of the more confusing conversions that we do, but hopefully after this video you'll see that it's pretty straightforward. With any conversion, we use a conversion factor. And in this case, one that instantly pops to mind should be molecular weight, which reports the molar mass of an element or species. And what we've seen this from previous chemistry lessons is typically as a gram per mole of whatever. And what's this mean again? This means that if we had, say, oxygen, then we know that the molecular weight is 32. But that means that it weighs 32 grams for 1 mole of oxygen. But what is 1 mole of oxygen? That's 6.023 times 10 to the 23rd atoms. So if we had that many atoms of oxygen, it would have a mass of 32 grams. So here's where it gets fun. If we have 1 gram mole, or 1 gram per gram mole, this is equivalent to 1 pound per pound mole. And you're thinking, what? Wait, this does not imply that a gram mole equals 1 pound mole. That's not true. So we know a gram mole, we've defined that as a certain amount of atoms. So a pound mole is not that many atoms. What this means is that if we had a certain amount of atoms that comprise what's called a pound mole, it's going to have a mass of a pound. All right, let's just get straight into an example so we can see how this works. Let's say we have 500 moles of oxygen. This is entering some imaginary tank and leaving at the same rate. And we want to know how many kilogram moles per hour. This is on a per hour basis. How many pound moles per hour? How many gram moles per hour are leaving this tank? So for the sake of conversions, a mole can be written as a mole or a gram mole, all the same thing. So 500 moles an hour of O2 is equal to 500 gram moles O2 per hour. Now if we want to go to, say, kilomoles, we know that 1 kilomole is 1,000 moles. 500 moles of oxygen per hour times our conversion factor, 1 over 1,000 moles, gives us 0.5 kilomoles of oxygen per hour. So you've crossed off those two. Pretty straightforward. Now, you'll rarely come across a kilogram mole, but if you're working with a large quantity in an industrial experience, you may see a kilogram mole. So how do we convert to kilogram moles? Let's do it the long way so we can see. We have 500 moles of oxygen per hour. Now, if we multiply this by our molecular weight of oxygen, which is our conversion factor, 32 grams of oxygen per mole of oxygen, we get 16,000 grams of oxygen per hour. So now we have a mass flow rate, if that's what we wanted, but it's not. So we need to go from this mass to our kilogram moles. So we can convert grams to kilograms, and we get 16 kilograms of oxygen per hour. Now we could use our same conversion factor. We could take 16 kilograms of oxygen per hour, divide by our conversion factor, molecular weight, which in this case is 32 kilograms of oxygen per kilogram mole. We get 0.5 kilogram moles per hour. So you should notice something. These have the same value. But a kilogram mole refers to 6.023 times 10 to the 23rd groups of 1,000 atoms. If it was a mole, it'd be 10 to the 23rd atoms, which is up here. Here we're saying we have 6.023 times 10 to the 23rd atoms. And we're using a prefix to ask in terms of thousands. So basically, they're the same thing. So the last conversion we're going to do is to convert to pound moles. So we want to know 500 moles of oxygen, how many pound moles of oxygen do we have flowing per hour? So let's use the same long route we did before, where we take 500 moles of oxygen per hour, multiply it by our conversion factor of 32 grams of oxygen per mole of oxygen, and we get 16,000 grams of oxygen per hour. And we take that 16,000 grams and convert it to pounds using a conversion factor of 454 grams per 1 pound mass. This gives us 35.24 pounds of oxygen per hour. Now we could then take 35.24 and divide it by our conversion factor, our molecular mass, 32 pounds per pound mole, and we should get 1.1 pound mole per hour. Now, the shortcut way to do this is by seeing that we're using our conversion factor twice. So we could just jump those out of them and show that the conversion really is just pounds to grams. If we take 500 moles of oxygen per hour, multiply it by 1 pound over 454 grams, and then just to make sure the units look okay, you can see that we get the exact same thing. So, to convert from moles to pound moles, we use our conversion of pounds to grams.